YouTube. So I got the new Freedom Shield on, just installed it. They ask that you leave the protective film on until you take it for a test drive and decide you like it. And if you don't like it, you can return it for your money back as long as it's got the film on both sides. It's got a little instructions here for you on care, how to take care of it. You don't want to use Windex or paper towels, will scratch it. Rain-X is fine, or I guess there's some special plexi cleaner. But I think it looks pretty good. That shape, you can see that little lip right there. Deflection lip. We're gonna take it for a ride. Let's see how this goes. I think the shape looks good though. And you can see it's definitely a little bit wider at the base, and I think this is gonna work good. Let's give it a shot. I'll let you know.
Quick run.
And it's good. Definitely an improvement over the other. Only ran around the block up the road just a little bit. Hit 65 miles an hour a couple times. Definitely no shimmy and shake like the other windshield. I'll be testing this more tomorrow before I take the cover off of it, all this plastic sheeting. But certainly there's no flex at the top. The other one was completely flexing right there. The whole thing, the other one was completely shaking. This is much thicker. One of the things I found with the original stock screen is that even though these bolts were tight, there was still play in all of these. So all four attachment points, this did not sandwich down all the way. The bolt is stepped, and it can only go so tight, and it's got two rubber grommets, one there and one there, but it did not tighten up on the other screen. This screen is thicker. The other screen is not as thick, and these bolts didn't tighten up, so the brackets were totally loose and were flexing, and I think that aided to the fact that the whole screen was shaking so bad on the road. But this is definitely going to be an improvement, and look for part 3.